How's it going? This is going to be a quick video just talking about the updated version of the HMY Revoring. The Revoring is a variable ND CPL filter. So it's a variable neutral density filter that is also a circular polarizer. And it's this system that works a lot differently than other variable NDs. So I thought I would just walk you through the features step by step and show you kind of how it works. And you can see if you like it. So what you're seeing right here is the full Revoring system. And when you put everything together, it becomes a thick stack of filters. But I'm gonna break it down one component at a time and show you what it does. Okay, what you see here is the core Revoring filter without the lens cap and the other accessories that I had in that full stack. And basically what this is a 1.5 to 10 stop variable ND filter plus a circular polarizer that can be quick attached and quick released from a variety of different filter thread sizes. On the back of this filter is a ring that you turn that adjusts the size of the filter thread. So what you do to attach this to the camera is you turn it, kind of hold onto it and lock it like this, put it on the lens, turn it a little bit to the right just to engage it, and then let go. And now it is on there, tight. Then you've got two little knobs here, and you adjust one knob for the variable ND strength, and then you turn the other knob to rotate the whole filter, which changes the angle of the polarization. Then when you need to remove it, you just do that twist and it comes off like this. Much faster than the other filters. If you've ever struggled, like in cold weather, with a filter that just won't unscrew, you'll know the frustration of trying to deal with traditional filter threads. And that's the main reason why I was interested in trying out the Revoring. Instead of a traditional lens cap, the Revoring has a magnetic one with a felt underside. So you just drop it on like that, and then it's very secure, and you pull hard to get it off, and it comes back off, and that's how it works. The Revoring is 1.5 to 10 stops of ND reduction, which should cover you okay in bright daylight. But if you're using a fast prime, like this 85 f1.8 that I have here, in the middle of the day, when the sun's at its brightest, you may find yourself needing a few more stops of ND. So there is an additional 3-stop magnetic filter that you can drop on the front of your Revoring that will then give you a total of 13 stops of ND reduction. So with this combo, you should be able to use pretty much any lens in any lighting environment. There is a limitation to the Revoring system. You could only use it with filter threads 67 to 82 millimeters. So if you're using a small lens that only has like a 49 millimeter filter thread, this won't fit. It can't go small enough to fit on a 49 millimeter filter thread lens. So this adapter here is the solution that they came up with. It just takes you from 46 to 62 millimeters, just like that. So you twist it, you hold it, drop it on your lens like that, make sure it's snug. Then you pull out your Revoring and you twist this one, hold it, drop it, check it. And now you have your Revoring on your smaller lens with only one adapter needed. You no longer need additional step-up rings. The drawback here, of course, is that this whole assembly becomes almost comically huge for a variable ND. This is way thicker, of course, than any other variable ND would be on your lens. Also, if you happen to remove the ND filter like I just did, it's kind of hard to access the ring and twist it the right way so you can get it back on. You have to remove the adapter, twist it, hold it, and then drop that on, and then twist the main ring and drop that on again. So it's kind of like a two-step process to get the ND filter back on the camera. But bear in mind that you are getting 13 stops of variable ND plus a circular polarizer all in one filter system. Most variable NDs are either 1 to 5 stops or 6 to 9 stops. Very few go up to 10 stops, and there are no variable NDs that will go higher than 10 stops. You always need to add an additional static ND filter on top of your variable ND, and usually screwing on that static ND is a real pain. So basically, the Revoring is for people who are sick of screwing and unscrewing filters onto their camera, and they don't want to use like a matte box system because that gets really bulky and expensive. Okay, so that's how this thing operates. Now let's look at some sample footage. Okay, so this has been my demo of the HMY Revoring Variable ND CPL system with the updated features. Hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please click like and subscribe to my channel, and of course, click that notification bell so you find out as soon as I post the next video. All right, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.